Hi there.
What's up?
Hey, this is John Skippy Limcool.
Seth Norman.
And we are very happy to introduce to you our new library we've just released called Toxic Zebra. And artwork is going to pop up right here so you can see what it looks like. This is a library of 135 patches and over 30 wavetables. And we're going to show them to you and give you a taste of the whole library. So you kind of, and not only hear the sounds, but maybe a little insight into some of the sounds, right?
Indeed.
Yeah. Share what some of the crazy thoughts going through the mind were when some of the sounds were created. So this library, like all of them, is sponsored by my website, PlugInGuru.com. And please go there if you need inspiring patches for all sorts of different plugins. Go to the Facebook page, facebook.com/pluginguru. And the YouTube channel is also youtube.com/thepluginguru.
Well, let's do this.
Let me show you real quickly a couple shortcuts. This is in the owner's manual for those of you. But to get to the patches, when you first get Zebra and you download our library and you unzip it, when you go to Zebra and you go to the patches page and you go to local, and if you control click on this, it says reveal in Finder. And by doing that, it will open up the Zebra 2 folder so you can open this. And this is where you're going to put these patches, is right here. Just drag it in. I put a space bar so it shows up at the top of the list. If you don't want it to show up at the top of the list, remove the space. It was a little easier to have it right. Oh, there's the new sounds right there instead of it being down at the bottom of the list. Don't want to be at the bottom of the list. You know? So there. Also, if you go to the oscillator page, which we are on, and you open up the oscillator window and on the local, and you right click right there, you can say reveal in Finder, and boom, look at that. There is the modules for the oscillator, and right here is where you put the Toxic Zebra waves, and that way all of these wavetables are available. So when you go to Toxic Zebra, here they are, all these new waveforms to play with. So we'll get to those in a minute. So that's the installation process. They thought of that ahead of time, which is really nice, because I have a lot of tech support email from Omnisphere customers trying to find the right Steam folder in the right location to put the patches so that they show up in Omnisphere. And Omnisphere 2 is totally different. Things are much easier to find and create and copy in libraries. It's focused more on that than Omnisphere 1 was. So that's good news. Anyway, so if we go to Toxic Zebra patches, the first 5 spots are set up as init patches. These are just starting points to get you going quickly. There's a lead, and it's got effect set up, a little delay, a little reverb, 4 oscillators going into a filter. And remember the shortcuts. If you right click right here and say select it on top, and over here select it on top, that way if I click oscillator 1 or if I go to filter, it pops up to the top. So, and don't forget to play the drive and change this to all around. That's the killer filter setting right there, as far as I'm concerned. Get all this. So without doing anything, you can quickly get into molding your own sounds, having a good time. Okay. Do you want to add anything to the lead, Sam?
I think that init file was mainly set up just to kind of like have a place to start for taking full advantage of the fact that you can set all of these oscillators to 11 mode,
right?
Which is really just a ridiculously easy way to get like a fat super saw sound.
Yes.
Right off the bat. So I mean, a lot of the time whenever I'm making a patch in Zebra, I'll immediately just start layering up oscillators on 11 mode. So I figured I'd just make a preset that has that in place so that you can kind of get to the next step more efficiently, because that's always sort of a foundation point for making like any kind of sound, like a bass or like a lead or something.
You need that.
But then there's also a million things you can do per oscillator on top of the 11 mode. And 11's not the only one. You also have quad, dual,
and single. Here's where you change your unison setting.
Yeah, so I mean, that's like the kind of go-to thing for me when I'm playing with the oscillators in this.
Yeah, and if you are going for a bass or a lead, remember to go down to global and change poly to legato probably. And here's your glide. And if you want it to be filtered, you'd go here and you'd right click, or just actually just click on it since there's nothing assigned. Say envelope 2, and envelope 2 shows up, so you can turn this down. And you're off and programming. Okay. So we have 3 speeds and 4 speeds.
Yeah, so this is basically the same idea, but you can go between 4 different subdivisions instead of 3. So.
And then triplets.
Yeah, and the triplets are... the triplets were a little bit more tricky. I didn't do a four-speed one. It seemed to work best with the 3 separate right.
Well, speeds. Since it's a triplet 33.33333,
yeah, the math gets a little
hard
bit
to get
funky,
that yeah, so. Into 4 divisions. Okay, so those are starting points for making patches without relying on a fully programmed patch. So these are like starting pieces of clay for you to work with. If that's the way you want to work, go for it. And then starting here, we have basses. And I'm not going to do this to every patch, but I want to point out one of the really fun things was setting up and standardizing these performance page 4XY controllers. And every patch has these set up, and there's filter, os, envelope speed, and effects. But the oscillator one especially will be different on different patches depending on what we wanted to. If you want to do chirpy. And if you go to another patch, you might find something like this. Where it just changes pitch on some things. It's different on every one. The filtering. I would go through, and I think Seth too, we would look at the minimum values on the different things, and if they weren't set quite right, we would modify them. So every patch literally has, especially when you take this and combine it with the envelope speed, so many different sounds. If you totally dry.
Yeah, so, those are, that gives you a lot of flexibility with these patches.
There's hundreds of patches available in every single one of the patches we've created. So when you go to Big Trouble, there's all sorts of stuff to play with. So we're not going to do this to everyone or we'll be here all night. But
so that one kind of makes more sense if you sustain it. A lot of these patches in here.
Right.
Sustained sound, so they have these kind of oscillations that sort of move
the motions,
over time,
right.
You know, and a lot of them are legato as well, so you can kind of get these gliding.
If you've heard his demos for Zebra, which are mind-blowing, there's a lot of these where it's like, oh, that's one part of 20 different things that happen in sequence to make these really cool synth lines, basically.
Yeah, so I mean, the way that I approach sound design and music is that I basically look for a lot of complementary timbres and kinds of motion in the sounds and then basically stitch them together. So I create a lot of the bass sounds in this kind of with an aim towards, you know, giving someone like me kind of a palette of those kinds of sounds to go through and combine with each other. But each one of these sounds as well could suffice as like a primary lead.
For example, check this out here just a second, and this is great. So we're going to go into the middle of the demo so you can.
Well, this sound is just one patch.
One patch.
And then cutting it back into like some effect sounds.
I love that. It's like it's monsters just coming out of the jungle or something.
Yeah, it's supposed to feel like a.
So
yeah, so that's You know, that's probably five or six of the bass sounds kind of being cut back and forth between.
So there's motion.
Yeah, yeah.
And it's meant to be just one snippet of that bigger production.
So. Yeah, or you could also take that sound and just glide it up and down the key range. Yeah, that's more how I play that kind of sound. And that's like, you know, dubstep or drum bass bass.
All right, so let's just play through. Hear that motion. All right, so the other thing I want to make sure we point out is that the modulation wheel on every patch is set up to do really awesome. And it's different per patch. So explore not only these, so there's five parameters that we program to do really cool things to change the sounds. So experiment with them because it's different on every.
That's the sound that you hear in the demo. So right there, that's all just like.
And then move the mod wheel so that's the speed of the LFOs.
Yeah, so the entire. That entire buildup sequence in that track is just that patch with pitch bend and mod wheel going up. So you kind of get that morphing modulation.
So the mod wheel is changing so many things because not only is it changing things in the sound, but it's also changing, if you notice, the effects.
And then you can piggyback that with tweaking any one of the XY controls, and then you get
it's crazy. All right, so here's Deep Solid Knocker. This is just it's a solid bass, and then it has hidden oscillator 2 right here. If you go to the mixer, the volume's down, and the mod wheel brings it up. All sorts of stuff in between. So that's the idea, is that maybe you need the mod wheel for your song to be here so you have a little bit more mid-frequency energy or something. It's not just for doing sweeps and stuff. So.
Yeah, I mean, that's a great example of the mod wheel just totally changes the patch
fundamentally. Maybe you need that instead of pure dark. So play around with stuff. Dracula drop.
I think the sound reminded me of Castlevania.
And I love the mod wheel on this. It's
it's pretty simple, but for the kind of sound that it is, it's the right kind of vibrato. It's so that it kind of adds a little bit of a bluesy inflection to it. But you hear that in a lot of dubstep tracks.
Yes,
you have
that kind
of
octave.
Bass lead.
Yes. Awesome. Love it. Epic swag. Big. And this does FM. And so this is an experiment with FM and subtractive synthesis kind of combined. And this is supposed to be like just a bright with a cool attack. Okay. FM acoustic. All right. Dang. Choppy.
Yeah, so this was one where I think I kind of took a note from you, because you were doing this with a lot of your patches where there's like an envelope to the filter that you really only get when you turn the mod wheel up. So it's like when you have the mod wheel down, it's sort of like a normal, just full of when you turn the mod wheel up, you get that kind of plucky, it kind of reveals a plucky aspect to the patch.
Yeah,
so it turns into a different kind of
bass. You can hide stuff because the envelope is doing something that you don't hear when it's bright. It's only when you subtract the actual cutoff, and then the envelope remains.
Right.
Cool.
Yeah, so that's more kind of like a scrunchy.
Cool glide. Right.
this is
and again, cool motion.
Yeah, so this one, that motion is taking advantage of the way that the FMO, the FM oscillators in Zebra work. And you could do like a whole video just about FM oscillators in Zebra.
Really That's crazy. Without the FM oscillator.
Yeah. So the FM does a lot. But also that motion is coming from the detune mm-hmm. functionality of that module, and also change it from mono to stereo,
right?
Which are the two dots set by the FM by input parameter. So that basically adds this stereo decorrelated aspect to it. When you turn up the detune and the width, it just creates all this really crazy stereo motion.
It's really cool.
And when you combine that with using a really crazy oscillator as the modulation input, and then putting all of that through a distortion
right.
and filter, you get some really crazy effects. But yeah, I mean, one of my favorite things to do in Zebra is to put just complex oscillator shapes through the FMO input, because you have
right.
a whole range of options for how the FM works per oscillator. You can make it FM input, or it can be filtered input, or you can make it self oscillate, and then you can choose from a wide variety
right.
of oscillator shapes
right.
for the actual oscillator itself. So you can get all kinds of different right. timbres just for making it self oscillate.
Yeah, if you go to the FMO page, right here is your sine wave shapes, and you can change that to. That will change the quality of what you're doing sound-wise. Hard sub-stab.
Yeah. So that's just like a classic like hard style kit kind of sound. Right. And I use that a lot in one of the demo tracks, in like the drum and bass demo track. That whole song is basically just sort of a syncopated rhythm played on that sound.
Right.
Kind of interspersed with the kit.
And also check this out. So the envelope speed... This is a macro that you just right-click and say envelope speed, and it connects it to all the envelopes. And if you hear the pitchy G, it does a really cool thing with envelope speed when it gets slowed down. You get all sorts of Atari drums. Off you go. So
yeah,
playing with the performance page will reveal all sorts of other patches beyond what the programmer intended.
Yep.
Is it a nice knock hidden? All right. Love the resonance on that.
You can hear that sound a lot in the track that you right. played earlier today. It's a few different filters operating on the same sound. One thing that I like to do with Zebra as well is you can use. I'm in most of my patches. I'm taking advantage of like all of the filters, even if I'm not really using the actual filtering on them a lot, because. The different kinds of saturation
right.
that you get out of the different filter circuits
right.
Are really useful. I mean, you basically every single one of the different filter shapes has its own flavor
right.
of distortion in the circuit.
Right.
So you can basically use those as kind of different palettes of harmonic excitation
right.
in your patch.
I hadn't thought of that.
So
interesting.
That's a great way of getting sounds to be really loud and flatlined, but also kind of rich, is that you just apply certain kinds of saturation
wow.
in series cool. or in parallel. Another great thing about the architecture of Zebra
yes.
is that it makes it really easy to set up parallel processing within a patch, because you can right. basically you can split out the path of one column of oscillators into another one and then apply different processing right. to that. So you could take some kind of core sound and then split it out, put it through a series of filters control cranked way up, and then like mix that back into the main path, and you have this awesome kind of composite right. sound.
Yeah, the ability to route around is awesome.
It's yeah.
powerful. And I hadn't thought about that with just having a filter in the signal path.
Oh, yeah. I'm using that in most of these patches. I'm just
because I was noticing with a lot of Seth's patches, there's like this big list, and I'm like, interesting. And I hadn't thought about that, but using these as a type of saturation for the sound, not so much for filtering, but just to saturate it. A certain direction.
I mean, so basically in Zebra, you have the distortions.
Yes.
And then you have the shaper modules, which are kind of like a different kind of distortion.
Right.
And then you have the VCFs, and you have the
XFs. Drive here, right?
So
yeah,
those so many all places. Of which have completely different saturation characteristics that you can take advantage of and use in different ways. So.
It's awesome.
If you go back to the global page, you'll see that the reverb is set up on return one.
Right. So you just control.
Yeah. So and the return, it's not actually going through that return path. If you check out the master channel, it's going through a mix module. So the reason I did it this way is because I wanted to take all of the low end out of the reverb return so that I could layer it well on top of the bass without getting a lot of muddiness in the bass. So I have the reverb going through an EQ and then getting mixed back into the main signal path so that the reverb is compressed along with the main signal. So you kind of get that sensation of the reverb kind of flexing against the bass sound.
Right. But not the low end. It's just...
Yeah. It's just kind of like... I mean, in the reverb in Zebra, unfortunately, doesn't have tone controls.
Yeah.
So the delay does,
right,
and the mod effects do, but the reverb doesn't. So
it does have a dampening, which is like a low pass filter to control the brightness over time.
It changes the characteristic of the reverb, but it's not the same as
it's not EQing
high cutting limiting. The reverb low cutting it. So
that's a cool tip. So check out something like ModPass if you want to learn about EQing and having reverb process only the low end's taken out for this reverb. So then it gets fed back into the mix. Cool. Oscill Grinder. Awesome. I like the attack of this one. I love that one.
Yeah, so the mod wheel on that one, it changes some it modulates some stuff that's happening on the FM oscillator. And it also just changes the pitch so that you get that really exaggerated kind of...
The module's taking down the pitch, as you can see, by 2 octaves. So...
Yeah, that's how you get that weird wobbly kind of sound.
So it's great for...
Yeah. Definitely hear a lot of that in my demo track.
It's very fun. Big sub, snap.
I use this in the intro on my demo track just for kind of like the
I heard it.
Sub bass hits.
Yeah. Mod wheel brings up some distortion, brighter sound. All motion.
Oh, yeah. I'd like to make a note on this one, too, for the guy that caught me misspelling Reese. In Toxic Atmosphere. I spelled it right this time. I named it after the wrong guy in the last one.
We've learned the lesson. This is Reese, not Reese.
But it's that same kind of sound. I mean, it's my favorite kind of bass sound. Tuned saws going through a lot of distortion with cool filtering and notching happening. Yep. It's just the best. Yeah,
that motion's so great, man.
That's stinky.
Should be to the DMB guys.
Yeah. Well, that's my favorite kinds of sound.
So just because it's toxic, the patches can do more than toxic. So, solid sign. And I wanted this one for all the D&B or the dark, like, garage guys that like to do a... Where they have it kind of go out of tune in the... Yeah. So you can do that kind of stuff. And if you get out somewhere, just double click these and they come back. All right, so there's your dark.
This one, I kind of used a different sort of technique that actually is directly inspired by another Yuhei product, which is it Yuhei?
I think it's Yuhei.
Oh, okay. Sorry.
Unless you're in the Netherlands or Germany, then it's Uhi, right? Or something.
Sorry.
The German.
Yeah. Okay. That makes sense. So.
I never say it right, I don't think either.
You're a failure European,
yes.
John.
Erz, you need to come here and do a video so we can find out how to say your company's name right.
Filterscape.
Yes.
It was like one of my favorite things ever. And I mainly just used it for the separate module that basically had a morphable EQ shape.
Right.
Because you could create snapshots of like 12 or something different EQ points and then just automatically cycle between them. And it was great for creating these weird kind of formant notch kinds of sounds. So in this patch, if you go to the global tab and you look at the EQ going into the compressor. So that's kind of a weird formant shape, and then that's being all of those EQ points are being modulated.
Oh, okay.
By LFOs, which is what creates that kind of like
warbly
kind of melody kind of sound. So that's like basically trying to implement Filterscape in Zebra. It's kind of a similar, it's the way that I would use Filterscape on other sound, but trying to bring into this to the Zebra patch.
And this is also using some custom waves.
Yeah.
Puke that width.
One. Yeah, the puke width. like pulse width, but more.
Yeah.
More
pukey.
Yeah. Yeah. That sound is cool.
Awesome. Kind of like Filterscape vowel in Zebra.
Distorted sound. Yeah.
And as a side note, I this is over 15. Probably 15 years ago when Filterscape came out, I did patches for it, and I did the demo sequence that's on the Yuhi website for Filterscape.
Way.
It's got Caroline's voice in it for the voice talking.
That's crazy.
So,
oh, wow.
Yeah, so.
I probably used some of your
patches possibly,
in like my first tracks.
How funny. Tornado Alley. And again, the envelope speed on this is great. If you want to get some chiffy... slow, then play legato and it'll just keep following, and then tie that in with doing this, and off you go. So then we have bells, because every toxic library needs some
those are nice bells, man.
But it's cool because the FM inside of Zebra is actually pretty nice, and this is just using a single FM oscillator with the comb. The FM is actually just the body, so the comb filters is what's doing the cool weird harmonic.
Oh, okay.
And I have it going through an alternate mapper. So you get these weird harmonic. But it works, somehow. And then you can play with the mod wheel.
Yeah, that's cool.
To get a billion different bell sounds. Because with Quark synthesizers, bells is one of the things I've always made a lot of the bell patches for Quark synth. So.
Oh, nice.
I'm a big...
You're the resident bell master.
I'm a bell master.
So if you were gonna tell me.
And a lot of dance music has beautiful bells and those types of sounds.
Yeah.
And then boom, this huge sound comes in, you know? So these... And again, you could go to these guys and just change it. The tuning, and then go to the FMO page for FM3 and change. And you can make all sorts of different kind of bell sounds. Just doing that. chunky riff. So we are into the BPM basses now.
Yeah, these are like sequenced tempo mapped
single note riffs. And quantize these.
Yeah, so you can just like drop that over a beat and you right. basically have like a bass note.
There's actually a pause, so the kick drum's gonna hit and then this fills the holes.
Yeah, it's purposefully syncopated so that you get something that would kind of weave in between right. a 4/4 beat or cool. some other kind of groove.
Yeah. Okay, dub, hot sauce. The filters in Zebra are so nice.
Yeah.
This is beautiful. Oh, one thing also to note is if you hit the information button, it will pop up the information that we've typed into the patches and the name of the programmer. And now you can just go from patch to patch and that will stay open. So you can see. Now this is the patch that we made in the last YouTube video. We made this patch from scratch. So. And this has a hidden LFO in it.
Yeah, that's awesome.
Okay, electro triplet.
Yeah, so that's kind of like an offbeat triplet groove. Ideal for kind of electro house kind of stuff. But it sounds great in dubstep stuff. I actually use this in that demo track as well as kind of like a little interstitial element.
This probably has your, did you have an Amargo? Cool.
Yeah, that just kind of moves the filters right. a little bit differently so you kind of get more of like a chirpy quality out of it.
Yeah, the chirp quality changes.
Distortion, you know, like that adds so much to the
sound. It does. You take this down.
Yeah. The drive parameters and the filters are just like really tasteful. You know, they add some harmonics, they reduce the dynamic range a little bit. They don't make it overly distorted, but
it's not too harsh. It's
They just add the kind of thing where you miss it when you take it away, and that's always the hallmark.
Awesome. This is using the multi-segment is actually changing the speed of this LFO right here. Yeah. So.
Yeah, so it's kind of like you're using the MSEG in a way that's similar to how we were using the mod mapper.
Yes.
For the those init patches that let you use the mod right. wheel to change the rhythmic subdivisions. Right. Except that they're just being automatically changed in
right.
a rhythmic way.
This is automatic where you don't need a controller to do it. It was interesting to try to click and drag to find the right value that equaled the timing that you wanted for each of the segments. So it took a lot of trial and error to finally get to... Okay, that kind of works. You know, right. So kept it. So, okay. Hybridized junk mail. This is using multiple multi-segments.
Yeah, and it's cool that it kind of shows them stacked on top of each
other. And I learned since the past video that you can click right here to choose three different modes for here. So if you want it to be, this is for moving the lines itself, and this is for moving in between. Oh, wait, so this moves everything. And this one, it only moves the middle one.
Yeah. It's different editing modes for
right.
the for
different
the
editing
ones.
Modes. So you can use these to control and change how you're moving. Because I was complaining a little bit because I think it was this one here. Oh, it's this one here. And I'd move this and everything else would move. So I should have been on this setting. And then I could move this and it won't affect everything else timing wise here. So that's something new I learned about. This plugin is so deep, it's okay to learn things as you go along, right?
Yeah, man, it's ridiculous.
I'm not embarrassed to say, when I first started using this, I was intimidated.
Yeah.
Because you look at this and you go, oh my God, there's so many things and so many slots and so many possibilities. And it took a little time to
crack
the code.
It's really deep. Yeah. So you definitely never get bored trying to do new things with it.
It's totally wide open for cool experimentation.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. There it is.
Yeah. Yeah, so that LFO2, that's modulating a filter, I think.
Right, so you want this to have some motion.
Yeah, that's moving the notch, and usually when I have like a notch effect going on a bass end like this, I want it to be a little bit more slowly moving because it just kind of gradually evolves the timbre.
Right. So the LFO1 is being used to control the input into FM. So that would do the harmonic shifting for you.
Yeah.
Nosebleed. FM is cool in this one. That's when the zebra is biting and chasing you and all that kind of stuff. Puke width. Is using one of our custom oscillators.
Yeah, so, and this one is also using kind of what I was talking about before, where I have some parallel processing happening.
Coming
out of the oscillator section.
And then going into the effects.
Yeah, so that branch that you see off of the main signal path up in the main oscillator section is going into return bus one, and then that is going through a series of mod effects processors, so that's creating a lot of
motion,
stereo dimension changes, and then that's getting mixed back into the main signal path.
Right. Awesome. You definitely got deeper into the splitting out.
I love that kind of stuff.
Concept,
man.
Yeah.
Like that's how I get the kinds of sounds that I like. Yeah. Is just layering up effects in weird ways
and finding the weird ways to get the motion out.
Yeah, for sure.
Cool. Ready for extermination.
Wow, so you're really getting deep into the LFOs with this one.
Yes, a little bit. A lot of randomized stuff happening. You could do all this. And I made this like a clap. I want like a clap variation. Just to see if it could do it, you know?
Right.
You can do it.
That's nice.
Kill the effects. Just remember, if you need to kill the effects, just crank effects to the bottom left and everything, especially the delay and reverb, is typically gone. Softball with a sloth. All sorts of cool pulsy things. This is the one where I really got into the drive. I thought...
Yeah.
Without it, it's... Actually, I have the resonance cranked. So that... The distortion isn't getting overloaded. To make part of the sound. That's why the mod wheel does that with... can find that weird place where you get the...
That's cool, though. I like that.
Yeah, came out cool. Straight up wub.
Yeah, so this is an example of something that you would make using one of those mod mapper tempo synced init templates that we made.
Right.
So that's essentially the foundation of this patch, and I've just built up a sound that's being modulated by that, but the control is founded on that same idea of using the mod mapper to map out how the mod wheel changes the speed of the MSEG, which in turn is actually doing all of the rhythmic modulation that's happening with the filters and stuff. Right. So,
and I found a lot of times it works out really importantly to when you change the mod wheel for the different timings, play a new note at the same time and then quantize both, you know, when you quantize so that.
Yeah, I mean, that's how you get the tightest timing. I mean, ideally, if you're using this to write a bass line, you know, ideally, if you draw in your automation kind of correctly, like sync to the grid in your DAW, then it would also do link up. But yeah, the best way to be sure that you're getting really tight timing is just to do a new note.
Because it's just times where it was like hiccup and accidentally, you know.
Yeah, yeah, and it's not set to like a refresh. Yeah. A way to make sure that it does refresh to the clock of your project is to use the global LFOs, because those actually have a parameter you can set for where they restart, you know, every one bar or two bars or something like that.
Right. So. That's a different type of LFO. I use them a couple times. Did you use them on this?
The global LFO?
Oh, no, that would be done on the modulation page.
Yeah, so you would choose it, and then it'll show up on the right.
Yeah, the LFOG, right?
Yeah, yeah, those are the global ones.
Gotcha. Awesome. So more wubs. Great. And this is triplet, so... So I had this playing a clock. Okay. So it's right there in triplet feel. Okay.
Bread and butter, kind of off.
Gotta have a
bass pump.
Yeah, sweet.
Kind of essential dubstep sound.
Gotta. So we go to the effects.
Yeah, there's a bunch of weird stuff on this one.
This just keeps growing and growing.
Yeah. Standard build up kind of sound, and
you need them. I've used this one. This is
fun. This sound is actually I gotta give a shout out to my boy Hatiris.
Yeah,
this is totally like basically an emulation of the sound from his track Spaced Invaders. It's like this classic house track that he did, and it has this very characteristic, just kind of like a wobbling high pass filter on like a rising sound, and it's like really, really cool effect.
Very cool. And I love it speeding up and slowing back down. It's
like,
Uber Builder. Is it great?
Yeah, that's. I mean, that's such like a cliche sound in house right now, but you know, it's fun. It's cool to be able just to drop it in. You know, it's really
there
useful
for the dimension. And go to the probably the OS page.
Yeah, so that gives you a whole other area of stuff to do with it.
Very fun.
So this is kind of a non-tempo synced version of that sound.
Right. So it shouldn't be in BPM, but it's okay.
Yeah. Why is it?
Since it's next to the Uber Builders, we'll keep it there.
Right, right. Well, let's say the delay is tempo sync.
Yes, absolutely. Right. Yes, yes. That makes it justifiable. Badass art.
So this is using the ARP, which I don't think we've touched on yet.
Not much. This video. The ARP / sequencer page, right here, has all sorts of parameters for making arpeggiators. Now, if you want, you can take the octave to just one, or to... So now it doesn't jump the octaves, or if you just set it to one, or to zero, so there's right there three different variations that you can change just by the arpeggiator octave settings. Badass ARP 2. So you can get all sorts of harmonic.
Yeah, I like using this sound as a build-up effect, because right. And it kind of gives you that kind of classic rave acid right. Kind of throaty resonance sort of sound.
And there's an octave on the pitch wheel, so you could start with. I think you use it that way on one of the tracks, right?
Yeah. On the drum and bass track, because it's just really good for kind of building tension in a rhythmic way.
Cool sound with the mod wheel. It's got that perfect mid-range, you know.
Yeah, the kind knock. Of rave at it.
So you can see here, this is with semitones, so.
Yeah, just program the riff in semitones.
Right. Fun.
Yeah, that's kind of a tricky pitch shift there.
It's awesome. I love that one. And this is one of mine where it works well as single notes. But I think it's thought more of as for chords.
Yeah, that's really good.
Because the mod wheel will bring in all this big, like, I just love those things where it sounds like there's a big modular synth hiding behind you, you know?
Yeah.
So you play a chord. So you can have this huge thing come from. And I Am Vulcan is similar, but with the arpeggiator set to do really weird harmonic things. So if you play a C chord, you get this really weird. Just doesn't make sense.
Isn't that kind of antithetical to the idea of a Vulcan?
Yes, it doesn't have logic.
Also, is this patch dedicated to Leonard Nimoy?
We could definitely dedicate this to Leonard.
Come on.
Long live Spock, man.
Perfect opportunity.
I hate to admit it, but I've never been able to do the... Since a little kid,
I'm not gonna
when
try.
It was on TV, I watched it when it previewed on TV in prime time.
In the Paleolithic era?
Yeah, and I still can't. My dang fingers will not give me a Vulcan.
You got time, man.
I'm a failure. I thought about, like, I have to put tape on each set of fingers, and just like after maybe a couple months of doing that, maybe
like a bonsai hand.
Yeah, that's, I don't know. So this has got that just weird, you put it into the groove and it's just kind of got this cool, you know, like you're a little bit out of control. That's why Vulcan's right. Kind of a funny name. Mental modular. This is fun because it's using resonant. You get these pingy things that don't tell you what the pitch is until you bring up the mod wheel. You can't tell what the pitch is when it's down. So you can have it play an A minor chord. Nobody knows it's A minor until some point in the song where... When you want it, you know?
Right.
And it goes to being out again, so... I was thinking Depeche Mode kind of thing. Scorpion Bite. This is using a segment. And notice it's not looping the whole thing. I have it just, right. I right click and said, this is the loop start, and this one's going to be the loop end. So you can do that. This has a pulse, this is straight. Okay, while chilling on Mars, it's got that kind of intergalactic kind of sound.
Yeah, it's cool.
Okay, Rhythmic Striker. This is one where I did some of this stuff on the Korg Oasis because they had the really cool DSP string. So you have these things where you hit chords. Then the rhythm comes in later.
Yeah, that's cool. Yeah, that's nice.
And this makes everything go away. So if you want, you can have it be like that and be like just... It's a hidden patch inside of a BPM patch. So.
Right.
So you only know this if you've seen the video, or else unless you really experiment with the mod wheel. So don't pass that up. So that's an Easter egg. It's hidden in there. You don't know it unless it's inside. Super Shuttle Ozone. And this one here's right. Oh yeah. Yeah, I love resonance sweep stuff.
Yeah,
so
yeah, that's awesome.
And you kind of... Okay, happy snappy. And it's playing with reverb and so forth, so... And the tempo sinks. Go rhythmic sitar, kind of like being a guitar. So I'm playing with decay and all sorts of other settings on the envelopes. Envelope decays are being done with the LFO that's set to gate, one of those gated LFOs we were talking about. So you can it'll always reset at the beginning of each major, so that's fun to play with. Warm steel. So these aren't necessarily toxic, but they work really well. I heard some of these in the demos because
yeah,
you need these kind of things, busily doing things that you then have.
You know, you can't have toxic without non-toxic, man.
Yeah, it's kind of a balanced thing.
It's the yin and the yang of toxicity.
Firestone. So it's just supposed to be like a more warmer, darker... All the dance stuff on the radio and stuff is having this kind of sound. So if you want to sound like Zed, that's a start. And Matrix Rebirth is a similar, but more like synthy.
Right.
Not quite so. Okay, Memory Pool. Yeah, totally. Mousing around for... kind of thing. Pushing the limits. So you got to have the pulsing 16th note thing.
Yeah, for sure.
It's very useful for that stuff. Stalker. This is more single note.
Yeah, you can play chords with it, but it also kind of works as like a kind of retro bass. ostinato kind of
yeah.
thing. It's very kind of like Carpenter influence.
Very. Kind of sound. Cool.
God, always gotta have a Carpenter type patch in every library, man.
Must. Smut. Sweet Insanity. This is using side chaining, but I have it really randomly detuning for a heavy wind. And that's controlled by LFO too, so if you want it to be sooner, you could say quarter notes and. And the other thing, these LFOs are cool for. So it's not re-triggering each one, so it's...
Right.
Pitch noisy down... pitchy noise downer.
It's good for breakdowns.
Yes. Must have. Gotta have some lasers.
Yeah, lasers. It's all about the lasers. Awesome. Standard.
More like a scratch, cool.
Yeah, it's got that vibe to it.
The effects that with the mod wheel up sounds like a whip crack.
Yeah, it kind of sort of like a small like hall reverb or something.
It's great. Clavitar. Don't ask me why, but I like, you know, the comb is so nice, it should have a. You always need this in your dubstep track, right?
Yeah.
Actually, it might work for it.
A little harp intro.
And I also set up the mod wheel for the decay. So you can play country with it. It's in there, so what can I say?
It's nice.
I'm soft-hearted with guitar.
So this one is kind of, it's like a minor 9 chord, so yes. It's all about either sustaining it, or you can play kind of like Detroit techno riffs with it. It's kind of like a pre-made chord that you can kind of glide around the keyboard. Right.
And if you want a different chord, you just go to each os to the tune. Play with the tunings.
Yep. That sounds cool, too.
Yeah, lots of chords.
Gotta have these sounds, man. It's like the old school rave stabs.
This is using the compressor, right? Yeah, the compressor built into the effects.
Yeah, well, the compressor going into distortion.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, it's because you get that kind of snappy quality out of the compressor, and then the distortion kind of cuts off the peak.
Right.
So you
softens it up a little.
Yeah,
bit.
It gets clipped, so you don't have like a really nasty peak coming out of it, but you still get some of that tappy quality out of it.
Right. Well done. Well done, young man. And then this is based on a patch that Howard Scar made that's in the 10th anniversary voicing. And I really liked it, but I wanted a different piano sound. And so I just started from that point because it played so well. And I've talked to Howard, and he's given the blessing for it to be in the library.
Thank you, Howard.
But his request was, because I didn't have the mod wheel set, he goes, please, put the mod wheel, it's such a good lead sound. So you can...
Nice.
It's just nice.
It's cool that the master let you improve on his work, man.
Howard is the master, no doubt. All the HS patches. For years, I haven't done a library for Zebra because of Howard.
Yeah,
the patches were so good, and so many different types of sounds. I mean, you go through all these. It's like, you go to stuff like this, it's like, I can't do that.
It's weird.
Howard, you're a genius. You're a genius. But finally we got the gumption up and we made a stab, and I'm happy with what we came up with.
Yeah, hopefully.
It's different.
Yeah.
So it complements what's there. So
yeah, it's a cool thing.
All right, Reconciled Keys. Boy, all those 80s rock songs with the big synth. Or M83, some of the current
stuff. I have a soft spot for that sound, for sure.
Great. And again, you could go right here and just shorten this. You go for that type of thing. So semi-acoustic, I wanted to try to make a wavetable that had a bit of a piano sound to it. And there it is. So Colony Collapse. This is way out there.
Yeah,
that's
pretty
from
weird.
Piano to
yeah, so that's the comb oscillator just going crazy.
Yeah. And I actually use this in the second half of one of my demos. Cause up high, there's pitch that comes through it, which is really...
Yeah, there's like an overtone that comes in.
Down here, it's just crazy.
Beehive sound.
Put that through some sort of a sidechain gate thing.
Yeah.
It's just a really cool non-linear noise mass.
It's weird.
Yeah. We like it. Cousin non-linear Eddie noise for the, mass.
Shout out Cousin Eddie from National Lampoon Christmas Vacation.
Oh, okay.
This patch is for you. He died recently.
Lovely. Lovely. This is cool because it has like these harmonic, brighter harmonics that come in over holding it down. So.
It's kind of the idea of the slow oscillation from the bass patches, but applied to a lead patch.
And again, you turn off these filters. And the saturation, the sound is still there, but the saturation that made it so unique.
It just adds character and texture. Especially, I think in this one, I'm using the LP Vintage.
Right.
And the drive circuit in that one has a lot of really interesting harmonic stuff.
Yeah, here without the drive.
So. Yeah, it adds this almost kind of like crispy, fluttery, kind of high
fuzz
quality
box
to it. Yeah, for sure.
Yeah, so... Very, very useful to have that kind of control in the filters. Hard problem.
Just a straight up ravey lead gotta kind of sound. And the mod wheel makes it kind of screech out.
Yeah, it brings... Laser Beam Speedway. This is a... It's fun and legato.
So as you start the attack every time.
This is another one where envelope speed comes in really handy, because if you go down here. Actually, I programmed to the mod wheel. To get rid of it altogether with the mod wheel all the way up. If you went really slow. Fun stuff. Machete. Nice.
I feel like you had that riff ready to play on this patch.
Yeah. Nice and fuzzy power rocker. Gotta have.
It's got like a nice squelch.
Love it. Puke Warble.
Yeah.
Yeah. Love it. Okay, this is Shades of Warm and Fuzzy, because, you know, Shades of Grey, the big movies. Anyway, this is 127 Shades of Warm and Fuzzy, so... And the mod wheel. Just a little bit brighter fuzz. Then I'll write it right open. And you can play famous old Eddie Van Halen lead sounds with this. Put it layered with the piano. I will not play that lick. I'm stopping right there.
Is that what you tell yourself?
Yeah, or, you know, the other one.
Oh, yeah, you gotta play that one.
Okay, stop. Oh, Lord. But I was in high school when that song came out, and it was, you know, back in the day, you learned those licks, and you drove everybody at music stores insane.
You still do.
Well, after learning it and so forth, even years later, like 3 or 4 years later, I was working at a music store in Seattle, and all these guys would come in and they'd look for a sound so that they could play that riff, and it's just like
it's like playing Sweet Child of Mine on the guitar when you're testing out guitar pedals.
Totally.
So
okay. Sorrow Mountain, another pad. Kinda had I wanted to have like a French horn string ensemble kind of quality to it.
Yeah, it's lush. It's big. It's almost kind of like a Selena type pad or something.
If you bring the mod wheel down, you get more of the horns. That's fun. And again, the OS page on this one, I have it changing warping and wavetable, so you get all sorts of white. Different bodies to the pad depending on where you have the OS.
Yeah, it's nice.
Unison, because you gotta have straight. But again, envelope speed. You can go from the darker pads. This is why I didn't have to make 50 different pad patches, because it's one patch. It's a Swiss Army pad. Yeah. So if you need the brighter, it's all in one patch. So there you go. Shy Galaxy. This is fun. This is using noise on the comb.
Yeah, that's cool.
So there's noise being fed into the comb to give it that kind of that rosin-y.
Yeah.
All right. Unstable Currents is another. Got this motion to it.
Yeah.
Complex harp pitch, we're to the plex. Velocity's controlling the. Dang. Crystalline Nostalgia Keys. This is pretty.
Yeah, it's got that kind of retro, sort of hollow, noisy quality.
Almost sounds like an opera singer in there.
Has like a formant quality.
It's huge, you know. Yeah, must do a demo with some of these sounds.
Epic trance breakdown.
Yeah, it's so much it can do. Here's another Pluck Enemy Mine. Just gotta have these. And this has hidden in it a nice, really pure, snappy. So you can play the mod wheel, the perform parameters, and get all sorts of different types of
Yeah.
Shogun for the kind of woody. And again on the perform page. All sorts of crazy stuff to happen. Snappy power. Cool. Strings. So this is an experiment with using oscillators for subtractive, the comb, and FM just to each make all strings all together. So nice. If you want, you can turn down these guys and just go through the list, and here's your subtractive, here's your comb, and then FM. And together they just made.
Big string sound.
Yeah. Back in the day with the DX7s, they made the TX-802, which had, not TX-80, what was it? The TX. I can't remember the name. The one that had eight complete 816, the TX-816. It had eight complete FM DX7s in eight separate slots. And Bo Tomlin and a number of the programmers would get into like each of the eight synthesizers would be made a small component that would equal this big, huge sound.
Oh, cool. So you can basically layer them on top of each other.
Right.
Nice.
Yeah. From one great big rack. I used to have one that had two DX7s inside of it. It was a TX-216. But I couldn't afford an 816.
That's crazy.
Yeah.
That's a lot of DX7s.
And it was a lot of DX7s. And the DX7s were kind of noisy, so when you have eight of them,
it's like it's trying to take off.
There's a little bit of that in the background. But so that's kind of a tribute. That's what I was thinking when I was doing this, was like, well, let's combine different synthesis and try to make a composite sound from. So there you go. Comb keys. Almost single line more than chordal.
Yeah, it's kind of a dense sound, but you can definitely do some kind of sparse chords with it.
Yeah. Awesome. More plucky?
Yeah, kind of brings a pluck in.
Yeah. Square rally. And you could go to, I think, on the perform pages. All sorts of different types of square qualities, from harsh. All right, exo keys. Big hits. Filter resonance. And then the mod wheel does a really cool harmonic. That's because the noise has the blown. Yeah, the comb filter blown has the ability multi-harmonic, the harmonic series of overtones.
Oh, cool.
Hammer to the head. Magenta Murderer. Really velocity sensitive.
Yeah, it starts out as kind of like a really dynamic, warm sound. And the way it looks like this is a lot brighter.
Cool transition. Mind squeak.
You play that one more kind of like a laser sound or something, like, right. Kind of do like a rhythm sound with it. It's good for kind of like alternating note lengths.
Right. Neon tears. So here you're playing with some of the other types of synthesis.
Yeah, there's actually. Yeah, this is one of the few patches where I'm actually using the geoblend mode on the oscillator instead of the spectra blend mode.
Right. Cool quality. Or spectra blend. Yep. Octave brightly. Just standard. I like those kind of sounds. Octave, this is a string concept, but with octaves. And poppy power unison. And power mountain. Robust trance keys. Shift there. Nice snappy quality. Spike riser. This is a tribute to a T-Series cork synth patch that a friend of mine made. This is using Envelope 2's Fall and Rise parameter here to go down and then come back up.
Definitely a reference to like Amber era Autechre.
Yeah. Two more to go. Theodic keys. Another big epic. It's like epic so many different genres are in this library.
Yeah. But yeah, I mean that's good for doing kind of like epic melodic build-ups.
Yes.
And
and off you go. Yeah. You know? And Tolchak.
Tolchak.
Who's Tolchak?
Oh, that's a Clockwork Orange reference, man. that's a shout out to Kubrick right there.
All
right.
Awesome. So there you go, 135 patches.
Boom.
Wow.
That was a lot.
That's a lot. If you guys are all still watching this, God bless you for watching. Now, really quickly, let me show you the oscillators. Not everyone, but I want to point out just a couple of things. There's all sorts of different things here that cover all sorts of really cool harmonic shifting. And some of these, to really appreciate them, you're going to want to go to the oscillator and tune it down, I'd say probably 2 octaves, and you want to set it to 11, make this go away, and turn up detune. And then you start getting some interesting qualities. And then there's shifting. LFO do that.
Yeah, I mean, with a lot of these oscillator presets, the kind of design philosophy behind them is that you can basically accomplish a lot of the kind of spectral shift you would get by using a low-pass filter or something.
Right.
It's actually built into the wavetable.
Right.
So, right, just by virtue of loading up the oscillator, you actually have this kind of palette of a low-pass filter being modulated by an LFO.
Right.
Or like maybe a distortion kind of modulating the depth of saturation.
Right.
So just by rhythmically modulating these tables, you get kind of like a LFO right. wobble or like a distortion effect.
And then you can use the LFO or the filter in different ways.
Yeah.
With the drive and other parameters. And have this do the actual.
Yeah. Yeah, a lot of these are based around the idea of kind of starting out with sort of a basic sound and then having it sort of grow into something really harmonically complex. But then on the other hand, you have stuff like the Oscilloraptor oscillators, which are just sort of a mashup of a bunch of different crazy effects. But then when you scroll through them smoothly using the actual wave knob on the oscillator, you get this nice kind of
mod wheel.
You get a nice sort of smooth transition. So you kind of get like this more consistent.
Oh, right. So it is morphing.
Yeah.
Cool. Now, if you notice, even if I set this to unison, and we talked about this in an earlier video, you set this all up, right? When you go to the oscillator page and choose, it resets everything.
Right.
So just be aware of that. There's a couple of solutions. Number one, I showed you guys in the last video the lock. So if you set the oscillator to 11 and then you right click on it, you can say lock. And now, let's see, if I do this and detune and lock that, now as I go through all of these, they will be unison to 11 and they'll be detuned. So now I can. So lock things before you go surfing through them if you want to check out how they're going to work in it. Okay. Other thing to point out real quick is I didn't realize this until recently that all of the oscillator settings, including the oscillator effects, the filter is really cool. It's really cool to have that into the oscillator without even needing a filter. If you set this up a certain way and you're tuning down to 24 down, so it's a nice bassy kind of. If you go over here and right click, you can save the oscillator setting and it will save it with unison on and with detune and with the effect set to filter here. All of that is saved in the patch. In fact, I was curious because there's a couple of these where you call it up and it has like the PWM motion and so forth on it. It finally dawned on me, oh, it's just saving everything.
Right.
And so as an Easter egg at the last minute, I made some unison patches. So you just click this and it will set it to unison mode. For square. So you can use these unisons as a starting point if you want to start from complete scratch, but you want a unison waveform. Then you got the warm chunks. A lot of these are very massive-y sounding, kind of.
Yeah. Well, that's kind of a natural direction to go in for getting kind of wavetable scanning kind of oscillators.
Right. So there you go. There's a whole lot of different waveforms to work with as starting sculpting points and a lot of patches. So hope you have enjoyed this walkthrough. We enjoyed making the patches.
Oh, yeah.
And maybe we'll come back and visit Zebra again another time, but Toxic Zebra is now available. So
yeah, I mean, there's a lot more to do with Zebra.
Yeah. So. In fact, in the closing, I'm going to play a demo and I'm going to pop a couple comments from customers already that are just mind blowing to me that they're saying is a really nice library that they're happy with. So, all right. Thank you for watching and we'll see you again another time.
Right. Thanks.